Hey everybody, it's Mindy again, and I wanted to share another project with you, and I thought I had done a video on this before, but apparently I did not. But a while back, I think I told you about a steampunk class. Excuse my desk, it's like totally a mess. But a steampunk online class that I took through my creative classroom, I believe is what the name of the the class program was. So one of the projects we did was to decorate a photo tray from Seven Gypsies. So I did this, and the theme was romance, but instead of doing romance, I decided to marry two of my favorite things, which is my love of steampunk and the industrial look, and my love of nature and the outdoors. So that is my take on this project. And all the papers were... Sorry, I keep hitting my tripod here. All the papers, I'm going to just scooch it back just a bit so I don't keep hitting it. All the papers were die cuts with a view, the tattered time stack, and the timeless type. And they go together perfectly. And I'm sorry about the lighting in here. It's kind of late at night. It's about almost 10 o'clock and lighting's not great. The first panel... I used my Tim Holtz On the Edge butterfly die, and then I covered it with Silver Beauty, and it turned really pretty. It just totally looks like I cut it out of metal foil or something. Then I created this little corset look, and I used some twill tape as a corset tie. Some I Am Roses here, and then there's a little metal filigree in here, and then I put lace and eyelet. And there's lace across the top of this, too. You can see that. And then the second panel, this is a graphic that I printed from offline or online, and it was from graphicfairy.com. Another I Am Roses, more die cuts from Tim Holtz, and then a little clock, a vintage clock face or watch face there. This is a little UD frame that I made, and this is kind of hard to see. It's so dark, and I'm sorry, but these are those little chipboard pieces that you can get in the Michael's $1.50 bin. So I just painted them all black. All the ones that I've used in this project have been painted black, and then I've gone over them with rub and buff or with the colored wax gel or something to give them color. And then here's part of a clock die cut back here, a little tiny Maya Rode spool wrapped in wire, little I Am Roses here, and then here's a little, just a little tiny light bulb, and whenever I see those, you know, on the ground or whatever, I pick those up and put them in my stash. And then here's one of those chipboard pieces from Michael's, and a little tiny bottle cap with a little, ampersand, or no, that's not the ampersand, what is that, the at sign. And then here is, I do keep hitting that tripod, sorry. In this panel, I've got a Seven Gypsies gear here, and then this is a game spinner. It's either from Stampin' Up! Or from Tim Holtz. And then here's one of my little UD butterflies, and I made the frame, the UD frame and the UD butterfly recently with the Martha Stewart mold kit. A little Tim Holtz gear, and this is a little middle flourish with a clock works there. Some more Tim Holtz dies. I love the dress form die here with the gear behind it. And then I have lace on this side, vintage lace. Bottle cap with a extra large bingo wooden piece in it. And here's one of those little Tim Holtz tabs. And an I Am Roses flower, a little flatback pearl, and then this is just a little circle punched key graphic. And then down here, sorry, that's really dark. I hope you can see that. Over here I've layered just one of those Tim Holtz, can't remember what they're called, but it says Time, and then underneath it I have Studio Calico wood veneer flag there, or banner. And then here's another metal flourished flower, and then on top of it I've layered a vintage piece of jewelry that's made out of seashells. It's really cute. Another graphic from graphicfairy.com. And this is a little metal charm. It's from Industrial Chic, and it says Fleisch Extract. I don't know if you can see that, but it's kind of cool. And then another I Am Rose's Rose. And then over here, this is half of a Tim Holtz clock die cut, and then half of a Prima wooden clock or compass piece or something there. And then this is another graphic that I printed out, and it looks like a gauge, and I crackle accented it and then cut it in half. Then put some flat back pearl here and some more lace on the bottom. And then in the middle here I have, this is my homage to love, and it just says for love, and there's a little heart in a cage there. And I really put my Tim Holtz dies to use in this project. So I've got the birdcage die and then the bird on top because I want the bird to be free. And a little gear for the arm, little industrial bird. And this little four is from Glitz Designs. It's part of their cardstock sticker stack, and I'm not sure which collection that's from. Then this is another piece of vintage jewelry here. And then this little frame, I got these frames from Archivers and I can't remember who they're from, but I used my Dymo label maker and did the love and then covered that with a epoxy sticker. There's some more I Am Rose's flowers, and then the heart in the cage is one of those chipboard pieces from Michaels. Used some flat back pearls all over that puppy. And then down here in this little corner is another bottle cap with a little butterfly punch out there, and another epoxy sticker covering that. And then in this last panel I have another little light bulb from my stash, and this is a little I Am Rose's Rose, and this is a little I think this is from Pro 31 Designs, little porcelain rose. And then this is one of the wooden clocks that I made out of some round embellishments that I got for really cheap at Michaels. I painted over them and then stamped clocks on them, and that's one of those. And it's layered with a little metal flower. And this is another vintage graphic printed off from online, and some vintage lace. And then another one of those chipboard pieces. This is a butterfly, and then I layered it with a key for its body. And then I used the other half of that Prima clock over here, and then the other half of that gauge that I crackle accented in there. And I think that's it for that piece. So that is that project. It's kind of hard to get the whole thing in frame here, but it's really cool. It's a little dark, very industrial, a little steampunky, quite grungy, and it's perfect, and I love it, and I'll probably hang it in my craft room. So hope you guys like it. I really appreciate you watching, and I hope you have a great night. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.